what do?
Stand up, fight back!
These activists cite that ever since the visit of President Donald Trump to the Philippines in November, it has emboldened President Rodrigo Duterte to become even more hardline on the war on drugs and his counterinsurgency program. For these PhilAms and their advocates, it means Trump is securing U.S. interests in the region.
I do think that there's a risk, especially with the U.S. imperialism and militarism, that our president here is supporting the fascism that's happening over there. They want all of this to come from the top down.
Activists cite Trump's own words back in November to how he feels about the Philippines.
And now we have a very, very strong relationship with the Philippines, which is really important, less so for trade in this case than for military purposes. It's called the most prime piece of real estate from a military standpoint.
To which recently, Trump doesn't seem to let up on those plans.
His State of the Union address recently actually underscores that he intends to dominate the world with U.S. military in order to push through the U.S. neoliberal economic agenda. And it looks like Duterte is falling in line with that.
These activists also point out how Duterte, who was critical to former President Barack Obama,
Mr. Obama, you can go to hell,
is developing a positive partnership with President Trump.
It looks like Duterte was lashing out at Obama for criticizing the war on drugs, for criticizing human rights. And now that Trump is praising him, obviously he likes that. He wants that praise.
Pam Tao Lee attended the protests against Trump when Trump was in the Philippines. She believes Trump pushed the Duterte administration in filing charges against leaders of organizations who led anti-Trump protests last November. The complaint is for violation of Section 13A of the Public Assembly Act of 1995, direct assault and resistance and disobedience to a person in authority or the agents of such person, both covered in the revised penal code.
To see all of this, hundreds of thousands of people in the street and this effigy that really depicted how the people feel probably got him a little pissed off and his feelings hurt.
With the recent White House invitation to Duterte, these activists say Duterte can expect the same protest-filled greeting that Trump had in the Philippines.